Hey guys, it's Danny. Welcome back to my channel. For today's Happy Mail Ideas video, I'm going to be creating some of these decorative bobby pins. Now, I know not everybody may have these little, like, kind of flat-topped bobby pins in their stash, but I do, and I want to use these up, you guys, because they've been sitting in my little bin of, like, my metal embellishments and things for, like, a year, and I haven't really used them at all. So I want to try to use some of these up. I do not remember where I got these, but I will try to figure it out and leave a link to them down below in case you're interested. Yeah, so we're gonna make some little DIY little bobby pin embellishments. So you will need some of these little flat topped bobby pin things. And mine came in like a big bag, so there was a whole bunch in there. You'll also need some different kinds of little embellishments that you wanna use. So in here I've got some chipboard pieces. I've got some dimensional glittery stickers from Michaels, and I just took the adhesive off of the back of those. I also have some little stickers that I'd like to use up, and then these are the brads and kind of like chipboard flare or whatever from the Echo Park collection from this year. So I'm going to be using a mix of these. So this was a sticker, this was a chipboard thing, and then this was one of the dimensional embellishments. So let's go ahead and get started on creating some of these. I've got a little mat here to work on, that way I can set these aside to dry overnight and I can move this so I can continue working on some other projects. So I'm going to set a few of these out. I think I'm going to go ahead and create like three kind of sets. So I will make a set that has these glittery embellishments, one that uses the stickers, and then one that uses the chipboard. So you can kind of see how the different materials work on the bobby pin. So the first thing I would suggest doing, you don't have to do this if you don't want to, but having a history in metalsmithing and jewelry, I kind of understand how metals work and things adhere to them better if you kind of grit up the surface just a little bit. It gives a little bit more for the adhesive to kind of hold on to. So I just like to scratch up the flat ends of the bobby pins just a little bit. It doesn't have to be anything crazy. That's just what I like to do. You could skip this step if you wanted to, but I would suggest that you try to do it if you can. And all I'm using to do this is just a random like metal nail file that I have. You could also use like a paper clip or something, like a heavy duty one. You could use the end of a pair of scissors if you're careful. So just something to kind of scratch up the end. All right, so to get started, you will need the Tombow Mono Aqua Liquid Glue. This glue is really great for this project and it does not budge. The little things do not come off. So I definitely recommend this adhesive for this project. So I have zoomed you guys in quite a bit just so that you can see exactly what it is that I'm doing. So take the glue and you're gonna place kind of a big pile of glue right in the middle of your bobby pin. Like so, like that's pretty big, right? And then all you do, flip over your embellishment, flip over your bobby pin and just press down. This one is not completely flat on the back of the embellishment. That's okay. I'm just gonna make it work. Basically though, you want the glue to come out from the side of the bobby pin and kind of come back up around the edge. If it doesn't quite do that, that's okay. You can always just add some more adhesive like around the edge of the flat back and kind of scooch it down over that edge, and that will help seal it in. Then I like to add quite a bit of this glue just to make sure that things don't really go anywhere. And it dries clear, so it'll be fine. So that is this one. I'm going to prop up my bobby pins on the back of this little post-it note just so that the flat back dries actually flat. So let's try it again with one of these like chipboard pieces. I think that'd be really fun. Maybe we should try, let's try this little guy. So this is a sticker. Again, all you do, I'm gonna try to stay in frame for you guys. So on this flat part, kind of a big pile of glue. I don't know if you can see this, kind of quite a bit, right, on there. So flip it over, press down. You want the glue to kind of squish out the side. So don't worry if it like squishes out, it'll come back kind of up over the lip of that flat piece. And then of course I like to add just a little bit more just to really kind of seal everything in there. So this one is done now. That's what that looks like. Maybe we should do one more with a sticker. Place a big amount of the glue on there. Flip it over. we want it to puff out. You just kind of hold it for a second and it will start to kind of come back in. Can help it along just a little bit by adding some more glue right around the edge. So don't forget that in addition to having some that are vertically oriented, you can also do them kind of sideways like I've done here with this 25. So just play around, experiment with some of the different embellishments you have. And I'm gonna go ahead and make some more of these, set them aside to dry overnight, and then I'll be back here in just a moment through the magic of editing to show you what they look like and to show you how I plan on packaging these up for my pen pals. All right, so I'm back and this is the next day. All of my little clips have dried and I think they are so cute. So now it's time to create some packaging to hold these. So I'm going to use some Project Life cards as my packaging, as well as some scraps that I have. And the little baggies that I'm going to be putting these in, the cards barely just won't fit. They're just slightly like too wide this way. So I'm going to trim down my cards ever so slightly like that. And then I'm going to use a corner punch to re-round the corners. And I will leave a link to all the supplies and tools I'm using down below. So once the cards are cut down, we're going to create a belly band across the front. So I've cut down some strips of scrap paper from my little scrappy bin, and they're just cut down to 1.5 inches wide. So I'm going to see which ones that I like the best to go with the different patterns I have. Kind of like the star one, I think, with the fa la la. I'm gonna go ahead and cut down the side like that and add a staple to either end. And the cool thing about using journaling cards as your packaging like bases, I suppose, is that there's usually some writing space on the back, so you could write like a little note to your pen pal. I've also created some other ones off screen just so we have some options to choose from. And then it's time to start pairing the clips with the little backgrounds. Then I have a few kind of left over, so I'll just set those aside for now. And then you just start sliding the clips onto the belly band that we created. So then grab one of the bags and then just slide in the card that we created, like so, fold it around, and there you go. So let's go ahead and do this one too, just so you guys can see that again. Although it's pretty self-explanatory, you just pop your things in there, scooch them around. And that is our little package. These are how the final bobby pin embellishments turned out. I think they are super cute. I love that they're packaged really cute, and I wound up adding just a little bit of baker's twine around each package just to add a little bit more kind of adorableness. So I think these are really fun. I think your pen pals could use them in a variety of ways. They could add them to their planner or scrapbook layouts, Project Life, their own Happy Mail projects. If you guys are interested in more DIY Happy Mail goodies that you can create using things from your own stash, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of those future videos. It is an ongoing series here on my channel, so I will leave the playlist to it down below in case you've missed any. That is it for today. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.